Hi, I'm here with Jonathan and Ryan again at Zipfian Academy. And I want to take a step back before we dive too much into detail about data visualization. I really want to get your guys' insight into sort of the background of students and what it takes to be successful in creating data visualizations. So I guess for you, Jonathan, what sort of things do you want students to know after their time at Zipfian?
Yeah, it's a great question, Chris. And seeing so many students work on so many projects here at Zipfian coming from a diverse set of backgrounds, I would say the most common hangup I see with students is focusing too much on some complex analysis or optimizing some model without thinking about the larger process as a whole. And I often like to tell my students, your greatest insight is only as good as your ability to communicate it. So if you spend weeks optimizing a model to be 99.9% accurate, but don't think about how someone might use it or derive some value from it, it's basically useless.
Oh, interesting. And for you, Ryan, I guess, what sort of things do you think students need to know in order to be successful in creating data visualizations?
Yeah, I think data visualization is really interesting because it's both an art and a science. So students not only need to know how to code, to work with the libraries and explore their data, but they also have to have a really good sense of visual design and storytelling to craft something that's compelling to the audience. We're going to cover both aspects in this course in order to prepare students to think really critically about the visualizations that they create.
Great. Thanks so much, guys.